So in any group discussion, there are two kinds of topics normally he gives you. One topic is related to current relevance, current affairs related, whatever issues are going on, he will give you that topic. And sometime he will give you any general topic on which you can say something, your views, you are to give your views on that. The topic may be philosophical also. I mean, you are to say something about that topic. So you have to introduce yourself, you have to tell about the topic, you have to give some positive points in favor. If you want to not to take the favor, then you have to give some points. So you have to add certain points, listen to others, agree with them, disagree with them, and conclude. This is all about GD pattern. So today I have come out with another topic, which is a general topic on which I'm sure we can participate and we can give our opinion. So let me give you the topic. You can write the topic and then we can start the GD. I will give 2 minutes to each one of you to introduce, and then we can open the house for discussion and then conclude. So please write this topic. The topic for the discussion today is risk taking, good or bad. Risk taking, good or bad. So keep yourself mute, all of you. So the topic which is given is risk taking, good or bad. Please write the topic. Topic is risk taking, good or bad. Think for 30 seconds and then we can start. Risk taking, good or bad. Okay, those who joined late, the topic is risk taking, good or bad. Now, I think Jitender, you can start the discussion.
Thank you, sir, for giving me this opportunity. Good evening, everyone. My name is Jitender Kumar, I initiate the discussion. The topic given to us today for the discussion is risk taking is good or bad. In my view, I think that uncalculated risk is which is done without planning is bad, but a calculated risk where you have something, some plan in backup, so that if you fail in your project or in your any of the activity, then you have something at the support and on which you can lie upon. So there are many examples, like the recent example of Reliance Jio, where the owner, where the company owner, that is chairman, that is our Ambani's, Mr. Ambani, take a calculated risk where he planned the project ahead, that he, this will be the like how he will be executing the plan. He had a roadmap before executing his plan. So I think this will be from my side, and now I invite you all to participate and give your views. Thank you.
Okay, Rupen.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, friends. Myself, Rupen Kumar Priye. I am glad to start the discussion. Today the topic for discussion is risk taking, good or bad. According to my point of view, the risk taking should be sometimes good and sometimes bad. But I think that like in exams and if there is negative marking, risk taking is very bad. At that time, we take the risk, but it unfortunately it worsens our marks. But there are many aspects of life, risk taking is sometimes good, like in many various activities, risk taking is good. Like, so I start the group discussion. Thank you.
Okay, Ankit.
Good evening, friends. Myself Ankit. I am glad to start the discussion. The topic given to us for the group discussion is risk taking, good or bad. In my opinion, we should take a risk, because every time we take risk, we learn something new from this. But it can be bad for us sometimes because it can harm us too if we take risk without taking precautions also. So that's it. Now I open the house for the group discussion.
Renu?
Good evening, friends. My name is Renu Gupta, and I am glad for this discussion. And in my opinion, is that a topic is very interesting. Topic is that risk taking good or bad. I think risk taking good or bad is the depends on the situation. It can be harmful, it can be good, or it can be bad. First, I want to take some example. First, if you drive the car, then if you take the risk, then it can be harmful and it can be bad for you. And second is that if you take the risk in business or project, then I think that taking the risk is necessary. Because risk exists in every type of the work. So I want to say that risk can be good or bad. It depends on the situation. Risk exists in every type of the work. You can take in business, in exams, in your family, in your career, I invite to all of you for this discussion.
Okay, Sagar.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. My name is Sagar, and as today's topic is risk taking is good or bad. So, according to me, it's not a certain topic where you can actually take sides. Sometimes it's worth it, sometimes it's not. It depends upon person to person. For example, a person who wants to play a safe side may never take risks and may never learn something new. But on the other hand, if a person is willing to take risks, it means either he is going to win or he is going to learn. If he is going to win, certainly he is going to achieve something. And if he is going to learn, he may direct the path for others. For example, one of my friends taking an example of Ambani, I also want to take example of Jeff Bezos, the owner of Amazon. He was in a phase one time where he has only two options left. Either he's going to be bankrupt, or he's going to be he has to invest all his money in SpaceX. Rather, he decided to invest in SpaceX, and look today, he's the leading example for the world. According to me, it always depends upon person to person, that and also depends upon type of risk, whether it is a big risk or it is a small risk. So, I will further extend our discussion for the house.
Okay, now I think we can go with Sharda.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sharda. I am glad to initiate the topic, to introduce the topic. The topic for the discussion today is risk is good or bad? So, this topic is very much of today's concern, and I according to me, one should evaluate first that what kind of risk is involved, if it is high, moderate or low, and it will lead to preparedness, that whether they want to take risk or they are ready for it, they can bear it or not. And the other thing is the evaluation. If the evaluation is done, they will be mentally prepared to deal with it. So now I invite all my group members to discuss and share their views in this topic. Thank you.
Satyarth?
Good evening, everyone. My name is Satyarth Prakash, and today's topic is that risk taking is good or bad. So in my opinion, it is very important to take the risk if you want to do something different. If you want to invent something new, or if you want to do something which others are not doing, then of course a little amount of risk you have to take. But I think risk must be calculated, that you can't just take a risk and think that, you know, whether it works out or doesn't work out, works out. You have to make a plan for that, that what you would do if it doesn't work out. For example, the best example for us is the Indian cricketer, ex-cricketer MS Dhoni, who was doing a government job in a railway, but he left the job for his passion to become a cricketer, and we won the World Cup under his captaincy. So it was the best example for the risk taking, I think.
Okay. So what is your name? Galaxy name is coming. What is your name? Please unmute yourself.
Sir, Satyat Prakash.
No, not you. I'm asking about another member whose name is appearing Galaxy. One member is left for introduction. What is your name? Unmute yourself. Please unmute yourself.
Yes, good evening, sir.
Yeah, what is your name?
My name is Pradeep Shah, sir. I'm from Kerala, sir.
Pradeep?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, Pradeep, go ahead. You want to introduce, right?
Yes, sir. Sir, I just got the topic about this, whether this is good or bad, sir. In my point of view, sir, it is always good if it was taken with due calculation and well prepared, sir. And without risk, no, always there is the face, sir. Without risk, there is no gain. So there is no harm if we take the risk. It may be, there may be so many chances that we will get the required thing after taking that risk, sir. But it is always good, sir, in my point of view. And you know, sir, someone if want to climb the Mount Everest or some astronomer go in the sky. So if that people will not take risk, sir, so obviously they will not reach up to that point, sir. So risk is always benefited for individual as well as for others also, sir. That's it.
Okay, done. Okay, now I think everybody has introduced the topic to the group. And now the second round starts. In the second round, you will be discussing among yourself and agreeing, disagreeing to others' points before we conclude. So now I open the house for discussion among you and maintain the kind of this thing, particular decorum in the discussion without creating any chaos. Please go ahead with the discussion among you.
Friends, all of our friends have given very beautiful, means wonderful point over that whether risk management, risk taking is good or bad. I want to state one line, like we all have some desire in our mind. We have some dreams in our mind that we want to achieve a certain position, a certain rank in the society. But due to the insecurity of being in the safer side, we don't step ahead, and we later on it happens that when the time passes, then we regret that.
But the point is, taking risk is good or bad.
Chitendra Rupen,
yeah,
I am agree that, but I have some points for the risk, that that is the risk is the depends on the situation. If every type of work, risk is exist, and if you cannot take the risk, then you cannot achieve your target. Actually,
but
I want
not
to
every
take
point
one example.
Fly, but some,
actually,
yes.
I want to take one example, that my example is that if you start the business with rupees 1 lakh, if you start a new business, then the risk is that it can be low.
Please keep yourself mute.
You can lose rupees 1 lakh, or you can be double or triple. So I think you want to take risk for the achieve your target, and risk is good for this situation. But if you,
yes,
if you drive the car, then if you take the risk, then I think it's bad, because it can be harmful for you.
I agree with Mr. Renu, but in business also taking risk is very, very bad. Like you said that this is like a puzzle. Like you say that take you like 1 lakh rupee and go to 2 and 3 lakhs.
But Rupen, if you know, you can't say that business, then you cannot achieve your target.
Yeah, I know taking risk is very important. Rupen, but
I want to point out a difference between taking a risk and a gambling. See, there is a difference between two things. Gambling means you just invest an amount without thinking about what will be the consequences. You just play it by your heart. But in when you are taking any risk, you have to be calculated. You have to be prepared with that. What will be the negative impact?
I agree. If you think about that, about what type of the risk, and you can bear the risk. You can bear the risk, then you can take risk. Otherwise,
I agree with you.
For the risk is that very important line is that you take more risk than you earn more. Earn does not mean the money. Earn, about the knowledge, about the experience, about the money, about every type.
Yes, I agree with it.
If you lose a huge amount of money and then you are getting some knowledge, then I don't think you want to do that. You have to take care about your family, the financial condition, and all other things. So I think suppose you want to start a business,
first of all,
you should learn the basics and you should prepare yourself so that, you know, if you start a business, there are less chances of failure. So these are the calculations that you have to make. You have to
actually, I agree to the point, make business only. What about expanding an other horizon apart from business?
Yeah.
Business is not only the place where we take risk. In this world, everything, like Satya, take an example of MS Dhoni, and one of our members also take example of Ambani. I take an example of Elon Musk. So basically, risk is not only taken in business, it can be taken in various, but you can take any type of work, and I want to say that every type of work risk exists.
If you want to take education, risk exists. You can be fail, and you can be success. So I think it's
I agree with you.
If you enter in the exam, then is that risk that you can fail and you can succeed?
Yes, I agree with Renu that this is a part of life.
This is a part of the life. You can be successful, you can fail.
If you have studied, exam is not related to this. If you have studied, then you will perform. If you did it, studied for 1 year, you won't get marks.
Exams is whether you like it or not. I think risk is beneficial, sometimes not beneficial. Like in exams, risk is not beneficial. I will partially disagree with Rupen. Risk is always beneficial.
Why I am saying? Because suppose you got success. If you are successful, you will be guiding others.
But if you fail,
then you will be having the experience and
experience,
you will be. sharing your mistakes with others, like the example of bulb developer, like Thomas Edison. Even he didn't get success a thousand times, but he learned the thousand reasons why he didn't get success.
But I want to say that in exams, like negative marking, I have to say that in these exams, taking the risk is very harmful for us.
Then again, you will learn the mistake of yours. This mistake will let you learn how to be harmful. That is why we are saying that planning is very essential before taking any risk.
That is why we are mentioning that point. And Rupen, I want to take one example also.
During this time is the COVID-19 pandemic. So I want to take one example. That is, if we do not come out the house, then how we can earn the money? How we can doing the job? How we can doing the any type of work? If you take the risk, then you can work it. If you
I suppose the risk. But if you are wearing mask, then there is no risk.
In the form of risk, I think, because COVID-19 is a
risk. To add, or bad, you should take calculated risk, as Jitendra said, and step out of the boat, as Renu said. No, nobody can go negligent just because of risk. They can evaluate and be prepared for whatever taking risk they are taking. So, we don't take risk, not able to do it.
I want to add one point. Like people who are risk averse, people who avoid taking risk become a little lethargic. Their movement becomes very slow. They don't want to learn new things.
That was unnecessary risk. Like in COVID case, we are roaming without mask. That kind of situation should not be. Like it is unnecessary risk.
That is not a risk.
It is about carelessness.
If you do not use the sanitizer, then it does not mean you take the risk. It means you are careless about your health.
I want to give an example. Suppose a student is preparing for an exam like UPSC, etc. So many times students fail in last stage, and then they have to think that whether they should invest one more year in their preparation or not. So that is one kind of thing. Like in AS or ES type of examination, many students give two or three attempts. But there is also a risk that if you again fail in your next attempt, 1 year again will be wasted.
So whether we decide to continue it or whether to we decide to back off it, that is a good example of risk you have taken. I would like to support that.
Yes, I would like to mention another perspective that there is also something called as worthiness of the risk. How much worthy the risk taking it. Like a student who is having his any kind of private job and he is at the last year of his age, like 20, he has crossed 27 and he is. Means he is just having 1 year for preparation. Now, how worthy for him he will be for him will be to take one again a risk for a government preparing for a government job and leaving his existing job. This also shows that how much worthy will be taking this risk. So risk should also be taken on the basis of whether it will be feasible and.
Jitendra, I want to say some point is that if risk high, then you do not work on it, because if risk is high, then the chances is that you can be failure.
I agree with Mr. Nur, but risk is the importance for life. Like taking risk according to the intensity of a person, risk is very important to go further.
Something new. Yes, right, Rupen.
I think the more important thing is that how much we are prepared for taking that risk. Suppose, I gave the example of the examination. Now, suppose you gave your first attempt and you are just missing the cutoff by some marks, then you can think that, yes, there are more chances of my success in my next attempt. So,
this is the calculated risk that you can take.
If you are missing it by a very high margin or you are not prepared enough, then there is no point of taking a risk.
I want to say that if the child walks, then there is a risk of falling, but still he walks and he learns how to walk and then how to run. So
what about the Yuvraj Singh, the final World Cup match? Remember when he almost spitted out the blood?
Yeah, what 6-6? Yeah.
Yeah, so this is the risk. I think apart from examination, apart from business, risk provides motivation.
Risk is like a motivation to him in for Yuvraj Singh's life.
I want to saying something. Yeah. If you have more experience, then you can reduce the risk. If you less experience, then you cannot reduce the risk. If you knowledge about the your target, if you have the experience about your target, then you can reduce the risk. Otherwise, you cannot reduce the risk and you cannot achieve your target. Exactly. And I think risk exists in every type of work, every time, every situation, in every second. Risk is existing. Every minute.
Let's hear what Shraddha has to say. She has also a point to make.
Can be managed. Yes, Renu said it correctly that risk can be managed. If he does not take risk, then he will not learn it. So, in order to learn and in order to succeed in life, he has to take risk and so that he can again try and some new things so that he can succeed in life.
Yes.
Now I think we can go for
according conclusion. To my point for...
Okay, now I think we can go for conclusion. So again, I start from now, Jitendra, from you only.
Thank you, Sabo. I would like to conclude the discussion. We had a very nice discussion and we could all reach to a consensus. There were many good points given by our friends, like Renu gave an example of depending on the situation, that risk should be taken depending on the situations, whether it is favorable or not. Rupen gave the example of exams which are related to the life of a student, that if there are some negative marks in the exam, then we should be not taking too much risk, as it will be unadvantageous for us. And then many other examples, beautiful example given by Satyarth, that of MS Dhoni, which was very relevant to the topic. And similarly, my point was that we should be taking some calculated risk with proper planning and management. This is all from my side, and thank you.
Okay, now Rupen.
Yes, sir. I have very good discussion, and the conclusion is that Miss Renu and said that like business model, risk is very important in every business life, and by the others said that like in business model, like Mukesh Ambani and Jeff Bezos, like in every part he takes the risk to go further, and without this they cannot achieve to the highest point. But I want to say something concluding, that taking risk feels excitation in life to go next. Matlab, this means that without this we cannot go further. But for the students, in exams, like taking risk is very, sometimes be very wrong to him. Like he can be indulged. Like he can be grow down. So this is my conclusion. So thank you.
Okay, now Ankit.
Okay, friends. I am glad to conclude the discussion. The discussion was smooth and we made some good points. Like as we discussed, that risk should be taken for business, and risk is associated with every work in the life. And if we take risk, then either we will win or we will learn something. And if we take risk, then we learn something new, like when a child start walking, then there is a risk of falling, but still he walk and he learn how to walk and run. That's it. Thank you.
Okay, now Renu.
On behalf of my team, I have many points for this discussion. First, Sharda said that if we do not take risk, then we cannot achieve the target. Jitendra said that risk is the exist the every time. Rupen, take the example MS Dhoni, and my point is that we can reduce the risk with the more experience and more knowledge. And next point is that if risk higher, then I think taking risk is the bad. And if risk is less, then you can take the risk is for good for you. And thank you.
Okay, now Sagar.
Yes, I would like to conclude. As I find the discussion was smooth and positive, everyone was in the favor of risk should be first evaluated and then it should be taken according to its worthiness. So according to me, yes, it's right. If you want to play safe, you may never take risk. If you want to play something smart and something new, the risk is something which can give you success, or you can learn something from it. So as all the examples as we have seen so far, according to me, risk also depends upon person to person and also depends upon situation to situation. So I would like to further extend the conclusion to the next question.
Okay, now I think Sharda can conclude.
No, friends, we had a great discussion. I like to conclude on behalf of my team that everybody agreed to this point that the risk should be taken in a calculated manner, and the final conclusion that yes, the extent of risk has to be can be reduced by taking some measures, and which will lead to the taking risk will lead to somebody will learn something from it, and they will gain more confidence out of it. And some of our friends have cited a very good examples in this, which were very related to, closely related to this topic. And yes, Renu said that we can reduce the risk by taking great measure, and we learn it from, when we learn from it. Thank you.
Okay, Satyath.
First of all, I want to thank everyone for this wonderful discussion, and we got some very important point. That risk taking is very important if you want to do something different, but we have to do all the calculation and take and think about all the possible results. If it works, what would we do? And if it doesn't work, what would we do? It can be beneficial in some cases, it cannot be beneficial in some cases. So I think chances of failure can be reduced by the more experience. And one thing I want to also say that, you know, if somebody takes any risk and if it fails, then it will help him in taking the right decision in the future.
Okay. So Pradeep, you unmute yourself.
Sir, first I would like to thank all of our team members who get an opportunity to participate in that a healthy discussion, sir. Although I didn't get due to some phone problems, I didn't take part in that discussion, sir. But as I hear, sir, discussion on very healthy, and most of the people here agree to each and every field of the life, there must be some risk, sir. And that risk must be some calculated and built in mind, sir. Without that, we can go. We could not success without that. And in my opinion, sir, risk should, I will conclude myself as a risk. There must be some risk as we see in our real time in past. Like one Columbus was there, sir. He was the sailor. If he would not take the risk to discover the country, sir, so we were confined to a certain place. So risk must be there, sir. And as I also hear all of our members, they are also agree that risk should be there, but it must be calculated. And I will conclude myself on these people.
You need to mute yourself, please. Yeah. Okay, so I think everybody has spoken now, and the topic was risk taking, good or bad. See, I told you that you remember certain couple of lines. I told you that if you remember those couple of lines, then your introduction will be very easy for you, irrespective of the topic. And those couple of lines is, good evening, friends. My name is Sagar, and I initiate the discussion. Friends, the topic for the discussion today given is risk taking, good or bad. Quite thought-provoking topic it is. And I would like to say that, yes, risk-taking can be good. It can be bad sometimes. So there are situations, there are particular events in which risk-taking may not be worth it. In certain situations, risk should be taken. Overall, human being growth depends upon taking the calculated risk. So friends, let's open up the house for the discussion, and let's discuss in the direction of when risk should be taken, when it should not be taken, and how to avoid the negativities associated with taking the risk, and how we can make it more safe and more exploring in nature. So open the house for that particular thing. I mean, give some direction, take some side, risk taking good or bad. I mean, take a side. What do you think? It's a good or bad? You need to take a side. And if you want to take like, okay, risk, without risk, there's no gain also. Life may risk is always there. It is not that whether you take it or you don't take it. Risk is always there. You know, the biggest risk in life is not to take a risk. That is the biggest risk in life. So if you play safe all the time, you are basically taking very big risk in life by leading the life without exploring. You think of somebody, some of you said the example of Dhoni, someone of you said example of Amazon, some of you said the example of Columbus. So all these guys, if they had not taken the risk, we would not have got the things which we have today. So yes, risk should be taken. And Renu was saying big risk, then don't take it, small risk, then take it. I don't agree because it is not in your hand or control, whether big risk or small risk. Depends urgency, depends is it worth it, depends situation, depends personality also. Why do you think Dhoni took the risk? You must have seen the movie also. Why do you think he left the railway job? As you said, it is a risky. He left it because he was so confident on his capability. He was so confident on his capability that he was knowing that he's meant for that. And he wanted to do that. Dhirubhai Ambani, maybe he was so capable and he was so confident that, okay, I will get it done. Wo ho jayega. Or for that matter, Amazon, or for that matter, Columbus. These guys were so confident on what they were doing that, okay, we will make it work. So risk is small or large, does not matter. The person who is taking risk, he should be convinced enough that risk is worth it. Risk should be taken. It is worth it. And I'm capable and I will do that. Despite of that, there can be failure. There can be a success. But as Jitendra said, does not matter. Even if there is a failure, you are learning something at the end. You are going to get some kind of learning. So aise aap introduce karne ka, you try to find out that format of introducing. Introduction is a format. It does not depend upon the topic which is given to you. That is only 20% part. The rest is a format. What is a format? Okay, friends, my name is this. Good evening to all of you. This is the topic given for the discussion. In my opinion, this topic is thought-provoking, current relevance, controversial, some name. Friends, it has two aspects. Risk taking, good or bad. Yes, certain situation good, certain situation bad. So let's discuss those situations. Give it categories. Agree or disagree with the statement. So these are the format which you should stick in introduction. Now, once you introduce, then comes the entry part, when you should enter. So entry part, may there's always hesitation. You keep on waiting for the time when nobody speaks, but actually that time never comes. So how to enter? How to enter? I will send you a link today. I have three small, very precise videos made, I think two, three years back. How to start discussion, how to enter in discussion, how to conclude a discussion. I will send you that link on the WhatsApp group. You just go through that. How to enter. Entry should not be done when the person is completing the sentence. Like Jitendra is speaking, and you are waiting. The moment he will stop, I will enter. You cannot enter because same moment ke liye, everybody is waiting. Everybody is waiting that Jitendra will stop and we will enter. So everybody will pounce upon at the same time. So when should I enter? I should enter when a person is speaking, and during the speech, he breaks his rhythm for a moment or so. He takes a pause and then you enter. So cut him short, cut him while speaking the sentence, and it will not look like bad. Don't worry. It will not look like uncourteous. You can cut him while he's speaking the sentence. So don't wait for the sentence to be over. You cannot enter. Number two, you should always be in impatience to enter. You should always show the excitement to enter. You should not sit like comfortably. Many of you are sitting comfortably. I tell you, Pradeep said he has some audio problem, so he did not enter. So I take that as a separate case. But then I'll say Ankit was sitting silently. Then Satyarth was sitting silently. And rest were speaking today. Sharda also, there was some, I think, audio connectivity problem with Sharda and Pradeep. So that was the issue. Otherwise, Jitendra was trying to enter. Renu was, performance of Renu is improving very fast. Today, Renu has spoken a lot, actually. She has spoken a lot and she has spoken meaningful things also. I will come to that. So that kind of entry, I'm to enter, I'm to enter, I'm to talk, that has to be there. And I told you one more thing, like group discussion is not about always what you speak. Group discussion is always, is also about how you present yourself in the group discussion. If somebody is speaking, maintain the eye contact, see him and keep nodding. Many of you are only referring to your pages. They are not even seeing this side. And offline may also, this happens. When somebody is speaking, you are not seeing him. You are seeing somewhere here. That is not good. Observer is observing you. So when group discussion is going on, you need to listen to whosoever is speaking. And you need to nod. You need to nod or you need to show some kind of gesture or posture. You need to move your eyes. You need to, if somebody is speaking, good. So you can show, yeah, that's true. That's true. No, I don't agree. No, that's not true. Sorry, Jitendra, I don't agree with you. You can say these kind of things, no? Participate, be more active. See, no, none of you is nodding. You will find the videos are already there on YouTube. You'll find none of you nods. Sometime I'm nodding, but observer is not supposed to nod actually. Observer is hidden. One more thing I want to tell you, do not address your discussion towards the observer. Do not say, sir, you are not talking to observer. You are not even mention observer. You are not to see the observer. You are not to see towards observer. Observer is observing from the corner. You are to only talk among yourself. So do not refer anything to the observer. That, sir, what we think is, sir, what we think, or don't say that. You are to talk among yourself. So this is how certain points you need to take into consideration. Now, let me tell you, Jitendra, I start with Jitendra. He said from the very first line that, okay, calculated and uncalculated risk. Risk should be taken. Risk is a reality of life. It is always there. Whether you take it or you don't take it, it is always there. But risk what you take is calculated risk. Now, what is the meaning of calculated risk? And what is the need of taking calculated risk? When you take a risk, there are certain things which are at stake. Suppose things do not move your own way. You should not have very high loss. That is called calculated risk. So when do you take risk which is not calculated? I sold my jewelry, I sold my house, I sold everything. Like Amazon example somebody gave. It is done when you are so much confident about your capabilities that you take uncalculated risk also. You say, okay, chalne do, I will do that. I'm capable enough. So let's sell the house, but I'm sure I will make it up. Wo calculated risk hota hai. Somebody said, okay, not having the hand sanitizer or mask. So Renu rightly said that is not risk, that is the casual behavior, or that is the basically casualness, or that is basically something which you say is basically not good. Careless. That is sorry?
Careless.
Carelessness, yeah. That is what you use. No. Carelessness. So that is not risk, that is not called risk. But yes, going out for the job when there's a fear of COVID is called risk. I'm going every day to the job. Am I at risk? Yes, I am at risk. Because I keep on going for the job. I come back home from job, office to home. So my family is also at risk, but that is to be done. Now we have to survive. We have to do job. We have to earn money for our family. That is basically a risk. But then you need to take it because situation is like that. So Jitendra talked about calculated, uncalculated execution and all he was talking about. The execution should be good. Risk and gambling, which my difference he told. He said it is beneficial irrespective of the result and it is worth of risk. So whether you should take risk or not depends upon whether that risk is worth it or not. It is worth it or not. If it is worth it, you take it. If it is not worth it, don't take it. That is the meaning of it. Okay, Rupen said risk taking is in exam is bad, sometimes good. No, see, risk taking in exam, that is not a risk actually. That is not precisely the meaning of risk. What do you mean by, Rupen, by risk taking in exam? What do you mean by that?
Sir, I this point, I thought that this point was wrong. That's why I thought that there was no exam, there was negative markings, there was a time risk.
वो उसकी रिस्क नहीं कर वो उसकी बात नहीं कर रहे हैं कि चलो रिस्क ले लेते हैं. ये होलिस्टिक फिलोसॉफिकल स्टेटमेंट है लाइफ का. एग्जाम में नेगेटिव मार्किंग ना हो जाए उसको रिस्क नहीं बोलते हैं. तो छोटे छोटे डिसीजन हैं. दैट इज नॉट अ रिस्क एक्चुअली. सो एंड इन द कंक्लूजन रूपेन यू आर नॉट टू एड न्यू थिंग इन द कंक्लूजन. कंक्लूजन शुड बी एज पर द डिस्कशन. देर शुड नॉट बी एनीथिंग न्यू इन द कंक्लूजन. Remember two things about conclusion. Number one, no new thing is to be added in conclusion. Number two, conclusion is not your statement only. It is the statement of entire group. You have to mention some people. You have to mention what others said in the conclusion. Introduction is your statement. Conclusion is the statement of entire group. And no new thing in the conclusion should be there. Remember this thing about the conclusion.
Yes.
Ankit, you said we must take a risk. Yeah.
Yes, sir, I have questions, sir. Sir, अगर कोई point sir गलत group discussion में मतलब बुला जाए तो कोई दिक्कत sir?
नहीं गलत देसी there's no कोई दिक्कत नहीं होता है मतलब आपने बोलना is very important और मैं तो वैसे तुम्हें बता रहा हूँ कि group discussion में marks इस चीज के कम मिलते हैं क्या तुमने बोला what you are saying that observer sometimes ignore but whether you are speaking or not that is very very important so first step is speaking.
Yes.
If you start speaking the with passage of time, you will start speaking sense also. So even if you have spoken something wrong, does not matter.
Yeah.
It is not yes. interview. In interview, yeah. I asked you a question, you gave wrong answer, then you will not get marks. But in GD, yes. there is nothing like right or wrong. You have to,
yes.
sometime you know what happens, like you must be seeing nowadays debates going on. Sometimes yes. you feel, oh, he's talking so wrong. Like Trump is saying election is faulty. He's a president, sitting president. He's saying US election is faulty. No, there cannot be right or wrong. It is his perception. In India also, some people are saying, no, arrest of Arnav Goswami is wrong. Somebody is saying it is right.
Yes.
In the case of Sushant Rajput death, somebody is saying, okay, should we focus and make this news so much headline in the country that for the months together, we are only discussing about him, right or wrong. So there is nothing right or wrong. Depends on what you are speaking. So you need to take side. You need to talk. That's it.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now, Ankit, you said you must take the risk. We learn something new when we take risk. And it can be harmful also sometimes. That is what Ankit said. Without mask is not a risk. So that is what he said. Risk is everywhere. You win or you learn if you take a risk. Either you win it or you learn if you don't win. So something is always there in the risk. Child starts walking, falls many times, learns to walk. So that was the example. You know, if you want to make your group discussion very impressive, start giving lot of examples, but good examples. Like if you give the example of Dhoni leaving his job and becoming cricketer, big cricketer, that is acceptable. Amazon acceptable, those things. But like Rupen gave example of examination hall, negative marking, wrong example. So examples are very, very helpful, but only if examples are rightly given. That will help you. That will help you. Others will listen and observer will surely remember you. In entire this discussion, if you ask me, sir, what do you remember? I only remember the examples, nothing else. I remember what examples you gave. Somebody said Amazon, I was listening. Somebody said Dhoni, I was listening it. Somebody said Edison, I was listening it. So examples jo hain, wo yaad rehte hain. Tum logon ko bhi examples hi yaad rahenge. तो देना स्टार्ट करो ना एग्जांपल्स को बिकॉज़ ऑब्जर्वर इज सम ऑब्जर्वर शुड रिमेंबर यू ओके दिस गाय गिव एग्जांपल एंड वेरी लेस पीपल गिव एग्जांपल्स यू कैन कोट समबडी यू कैन गिव एग्जांपल एंड एग्जांपल नीड नॉट टू बी वेरी बिग दे आर इन एंड अराउंड यू अब धोनी का एग्जांपल मे बी अमेज़न का एग्जांपल नॉट एवरीबॉडी नोस कि अमेज़न का जो चीफ था ही हैज डन लाइक दैट मे बी पीपल आर नॉट नोइंग पर धोनी मूवी तो सभी ने देखी हुई है यार वो एग्जांपल तो तुम दे ही सकते हो That way, you have to give some examples that makes your discussion very, very impressive. Renu, you are improving fast. You spoke a lot. You said it is an interesting topic and you said it depends upon the situation. So risk is good or bad. It depends upon the situation. In some situation, you have to take a risk. And that is good. Like I gave you example. Presently, everybody is going on job. Earlier, you were avoiding going to office. Think of March, April, entire curfew. You are not going out. You are fearing this virus. Same virus in more dangerous position is existing now. But we are going out. We are not fearing. We are taking risk. Why? Because now the situation is we have to earn. We have to feed our families. So we are entire India is taking risk. Entire humanity is taking risk. Why? Because we have to survive. So situation is like that. So, क्या हुआ भाई मार्च अप्रैल में तो तुम घर से बाहर नहीं जा रहे थे अब तुम घर से बाहर क्यों जा रहे हो Why you are taking risk now? Situation is like that. It is not a big risk, small risk, worth it, not worth it. It is situation also will make you take risk. sometimes you have to jump. You have to jump from building mein aag lag jaye. Will you not jump from second floor or first floor? You will make a risk. Okay, yaar, aag mein jalne se marne se acha jump kar jate ho. Haath waath tootega, lekin we may survive. You take a risk. So situation actually is the important. You gave example of driving a car. That is not good risk. Business mein you take a risk. That is acceptable example. So as I said, give example. Renu gave the example. If you are driving a car, don't take risk. And if you are in the business, take risk. Depends situation. You know, when you drive car very fast, you are called foolish. But when you put a lot of effort in the business, you are not called foolish. This is how situation is also different. Renu said risk is everywhere. And high risk, low risk, I do not agree, Renu, with you. High risk, low risk. But you also said that, okay, with experience and knowledge, risk can be reduced. Risk can be reduced. So there is something which is called risk mitigation. Reduce karna risk ko, mitigation ko. Information, knowledge, practice, experience, strategies, planning. Isse risk mitigation can be there. You guys are engineers, most of you. So you have done risk management is a part of your syllabus. If not college, then engineering services syllabus is risk management is a part of that. So somewhere you must have gone through that. Sagar, you said sometimes worth, sometimes it is not worth. Person to person. Sagar said person to person varies. Either you win it or you learn out of it. Owner of Amazon ka example you gave, small, big risk you said. And in the conclusion, you said we must evaluate it. And then we should take the risk and don't play safe always. So these things, you know, like evaluation, strategy, planning, mitigation, ye risk management subject ke phrases, phraseology hai, ABC of risk management. So if you use these terms, this will help you. Whenever you are given option to take negative view, to take positive view, normally if you take positive view, it always help you. It is something which is good. So try to take positive opinion about certain things. It helps you. Like, should I take risk or not? Yes, sir, you should take a risk, calculated risk, risk mitigation. It will teach you something. Sir, should I write UPSC exam or not? What is the probability of success in IAS exam? 0%. Almost everybody fails. So out of 3 lakh, only 30 will become IAS. What is the probability of success? 30 divided by 3 lakh. What percentage? 0% almost. So that means if I write this exam, I'll fail. Should I go for it? I'll say, yes, you should go for it. Why? You may become. Because those who become, they have taken the same risk. Number two, if you don't become, you will learn something out of it. You will become more knowledgeable individual, confident individual. You can guide somebody in future. So that way you take a positive opinion. That is how Sagar said. And Sharda, then one should first evaluate and then see whether risk is high, moderate and low. Preparedness, evaluation, those things you have to do it. You mentioned about risk categories. Actually, risks should be high or moderate or low. Risk are of different categories. That is true, but risk taking good or bad does not depend upon the category. Sometimes you are to take high risk situation. Sometimes you will not even take the small risk. Why should I take a small risk? I'll not take. It is not worth it. I don't need it. Yaar, tune bada risk le liya, chota risk tune liya nahi. Kyun? Kyunki situation ne permit nahi kiya. But a risky situation thi, I was to take big risk. So, you know, if a small child gets into the cage of lion, his mother will fight with the lion. Why? To save the kid. Very high risk. But she is taking that chance. Why? To save her child. So high risk, low risk, wo situation ke upar depend karta hai. You did not enter Sharda in entire discussion. You were sitting, but you were not trying to enter. Though you were trying, but you could not succeed. Try again. Learn it, and that will come with experience only. Conclusion is of the group. As I told you, when you were concluding, you need to include others also. Conclusion is not your point of view. Conclusion is of the point of view of entire team. So you need to conclude that way. You need to put those things also together. Satyarth, you said something. If there is something new, then calculated risk should be taken. I mean, you can take calculated risk. That is what you said. You gave example of MS Dhoni, government job, railways, UPSC may taking risk. You mentioned about that also. Then how much are we prepared to take risk? You said risk taking also depends upon how much you are prepared. Not always. When you have to take risk, sometimes you are not prepared at all. Sometimes you are not at all prepared. And in fact, in certain things, you do not know what is the preparation is. What is the preparation? You do not know that. Other than your capabilities, you do not know anything. Edison was only confident about his capabilities. Someday, I will keep on pushing. Dhoni was only capable of his capability. Had you asked Dhoni, will you become very big cricketer? He could not have said. That is not in his hand. Edison, after how many experiments will you get a bulb? He will not say and give you any answer because these guys don't know. But if you ask Dhoni or Edison, do you like what you are doing? Yes. Are you capable in that? Yes. Do you think you can do it? Yes, I can do it. When? I don't know. So actually, they are only confident about their capabilities. They do not know about the result. So result focused, we cannot do the risk analysis. You thanked everybody for the participation in discussion. That was a good conclusion way. I mean, when you are concluding, it is good that you thank everybody. In the introduction, you welcome everybody. Okay, friends, I welcome all of you to the discussion, and I'm very sure you are going to give your good points. In the conclusion, you say, friends, I thank all of you for this wonderful discussion, and all of you gave very good points. We could reach the consensus. Now, let me put the things in order, what we concluded. So, aisa bolo na yaar. वेलकम करो इंट्रोडक्शन में और थैंक्स करो कंक्लूजन के अंदर जितना द मोर यू विल मेक इट ऑटो मोड द मोर यू विल मेक दिस एंटायर थिंग ऑटो मोड स्ट्रक्चर्ड इजियर इट विल बी फॉर यू इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ एनी डिस्कशन स्टार्टिंग विल बी सेम एवरी टाइम स्टार्टिंग विल बी सेम यू नो हैव यू सीन दिस क्रिकेटर्स गिविंग देयर स्पीचेस एट द एंड ऑफ द मैच मैन ऑफ द मैच व्हेन इट इज गिवन लाइक धोनी एंड ऑल These guys are not very good in communication. They are cricketers. They do not speak very good initially. But after 1 year or 2 years, they start speaking very fluently. Like Dhoni and all, Ganguly, Dhoni. And they will say the same thing. After every match, they will say the same thing. Okay, the ball was coming on the bat and light was good. The pitch was good. The boys were cooperating, this thing, that. Same lines. They have remembered only 10, 15 lines. And they shuffle these lines. And they say after every match. Same in GD, you have to remember a couple of lines. And you have to use those lines in introduction, in conclusion, and when you enter also. And hence, GD will become very easy. So it is a format. You need to remember that format. You need to follow that format. That's it. Pradeep, you said calculation, no gain, no risk. So if there is no risk, you will not gain anything. Always, risk taking is always good. So you supported that, yes, risk taking is a good thing. But you did not mention about when it is bad. In fact, none of you talked about when risk is bad. Risk taking good or bad? I agree it is good. Is it bad also? Yes, it is bad also. When? When risk taking is bad? None of you said much about that. You should talk about that also. I will come to that.
Sir, whatever I told about the preparation, that was about that aspect. That if you are not prepared enough, then of course, there are more chances of failure. That, you know, I gave the example that if in your first attempt you are just missing the cutoff by some marks, then there are more chances that you will succeed in next attempt. Similarly, if a cricketer is playing very well at domestic level and he is performing really well, then he knows that yes, even in 1 or 2 years I will be called for the selection. But if somebody is failing by a very large margin or he is not prepared enough, suppose I'm a student and I have no knowledge about the business world or something, and I just take a risk of very huge amount in business, then of course there are more chances of failure. So preparation in that aspect, that if you want to start something new, you have to, you know, learn about it. You have to prepare yourself in terms of everything. It's technicalities or all the preparation that is needed.
Yes, that is one aspect only. I'll say that is one aspect only. Preparedness. But then there's the other aspect also. Is it worth it or not? I'm very much prepared. Obviously, civil services, I'm to write, I'm prepared, I'm giving my 4 or 5 years. But is it worth it? You don't want to become IAS. It does not suit your temperament. Still, you are spending 5 years of your life, 4 years of your life, preparation of this exam. It is not worth it. So sometimes things are not worth it. You are driving it very fast after drinking. It is not worth it. You are driving without helmet. It is not worth it. Without helmet, you are driving, you are taking risk. And you're going, and maybe accident, then head injury can be there. It is not worth it. So sometimes it is not worth it. Sometimes it is not matching your requirement. You don't need it. Still, you're taking risk. So there should be strong reason behind taking risk. You said preparation should also be there. Agreed. It should be worth it. These are some of the aspects when you should take risk and when you should not take risk. So this is something which you have to think about. So this is all about, I think. So if I'm to give the feedback today, then I'll say Jitendra has done good. Renu has spoken. Sagar has spoken. And then Satyarth, you have spoken. But Sharda and Pradeep, I could not listen much. Rupen, you have to come over as of now. You have to come out, come into this. So if I'm to reject today's discussion, I'll reject Pradeep, I'll reject Rupen, I'll reject Sharda also. And if I'm to select very clearly, I'll select Jitendra, Sagar and Satyarth. And Renu is also to be selected. She will also get selected in this particular discussion today. So these four guys selected and three guys are border case. Which this thing basically I am to do. But when I'm saying rejecting, I'm not giving zero. Pradeep ka case is different. He did not speak because I think audio situation was there. Rupen is at the border. Little bit more effort, you will be in. And Sharda can speak, but today because of the audio, I think she is not in position to speak. So this is the present situation of all of you, and I've given you feedback also. So work in this particular direction. Now, anything else you want to ask?
Sir, mera ek question tha. सर एक्चुअली मेरे पास IOSL की एक मेल आई थी वो शायद उसके लिए इंटरव्यू के लिए, लेकिन सर मैंने उसको देखा तो उसमें मतलब डेट कहीं मेंशन नहीं थी, मुझे कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा उसमें सर एक्चुअली.
फिर से बोलना
सर मेरे पास IOSL की मेल आई थी इंटरव्यू के लिए.
ओके
सर मुझे उसमें समझ नहीं आ रहा, उसमें कुछ डेट वगैरह कुछ नहीं है, कोई मेंशन नहीं है, और मतलब मुझे समझ नहीं आ रहा वो उन्होंने मुझे किस पर्पस के लिए वो मेल भेजी है.
आरोग्य सेतु करके आप मेल आया होगा, उसमें कुछ मेंशन
आरोग्य सेतु से नहीं आया, मेरे पास IOCL से ही आया है.
आप रेनु वालों का ही मेल आया है? यस सर,
गो अहेड सागर.
IOCL वालों का ये एक मेल आया है जिसमें उन्होंने ये मेंशन किया है कि आपको अपने मोबाइल में आरोग्य सेतु डालना है. ये हो सकता है
नहीं, डेट चाहिए तो डेट के लिए IOCL में जहाँ पे लॉग इन करना था वहाँ पे लॉग इन करना होगा. लॉग इन करने पर डेट पता
चलेगा. मेल भी आया
है, मेल बस एक तरह से कॉलिंग के लिए.
ओके तो कॉलिंग भी आती है क्या?
क्या?
हाँ जब
भी आती है.
हाँ जिसको भी कॉल किया उन्होंने इंटरव्यू के लिए, एक मेल सबको जाएगी.
हाँ एक मेल तो सबको आया
किया गया, लेकिन डेट और वेन्यू जो है वो लॉगिन करने पे मिलेगा.
कॉल नहीं आती, सिर्फ मेल आता है.
ओके ओके
सर
मेल में डेट नहीं है.
यस मेल में डेट नहीं है.
मेल में वो उन्होंने पहले भेजा था वही मेल वापस कर दिया कि यू हैव शॉर्टलिस्टेड और फिर डिटेल्स लिखी हुई है हमारी.
यस यस या हां वही चीज.
वेन्यू कोई डेट कोई शेड्यूल कुछ भी लिखा हुआ है? एक्चुअली शेड्यूल का ही मेल है और उससे कोई शेड्यूल नहीं है, तो वो हम लोग को डाउट है.
तो वही वही चीज कह रहा हूँ. साइट पे जहाँ फॉर्म भरा था ना, वहाँ पे लॉग इन करो. यूजर जो मेल आईडी और पासवर्ड था जो बनाया था फॉर्म फिलिंग के टाइम,
हाँ,
तो उसमें ओपन हाँ, करने पे वो देगा, डेट भी देगा और कहाँ इंटरव्यू सेंटर वो मिल जाएगा. वही सबसे बायोडाटा फिल करना. और नीचे स्क्रॉल करने पे आएगा.
कुछ भी नहीं है, प्रिंट एप्लीकेशन करके लिखा है और वही जो हमने एप्लीकेशन बनाई.
हाँ मेरे में भी सेम यही चीज आ रही है.
तो IOCL में कांटेक्ट कर लो, कांटेक्ट नंबर होगा कुछ?
मेरे पास तो नहीं है, अगर आपके पास है तो.
नहीं वेबसाइट पे बोला मैंने, मतलब मेरे पास पर्सनली तो नहीं है, वेबसाइट पे शायद मिल जाए.
अच्छा 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 ठीक है.
वेबसाइट पे दिया हुआ है, पर अपने सोचा एक दो मिनट वेट कर लेते हैं, मिल जाएगा अपने पास, आ जाएगी मेल.
तो डेट्स तो आ गई है ना पास, मेरे हिसाब से तो आपको कर देना चाहिए अभी तक, क्योंकि डेट्स ऑलमोस्ट आ गई है और इंटरव्यू चालू भी हो गए. ब्रांच कौन सी है?
गेट वालों के है, इंजीनियर्स के है.
अच्छा अच्छा हाँ हाँ
नहीं आए.
आप जीटी करवा रहे हैं सर, एक दो सेशन सर जीटी के भी करवा लीजिए सर. IOCL में
नेक्स्ट जीटी कर लेते हैं. जीटी पहले उसको देखो जो पड़ा हुआ है ना उसपे, आपका यूट्यूब पे जीटी पड़ा हुआ है, इसपे इसके काफी जीटी पड़े हुए IOCL के, और फिर नेक्स्ट हम जीटी कर लेंगे. नेक्स्ट विल बी जीटी ओनली.
जीटी के रिगार्डिंग आपकी कोई वीडियो है यूट्यूब पे?
बहुत है.
क्योंकि सर मैंने IOCL की GT की मतलब अभी तक जितने भी थे मैंने देखे, तो उनके GT में दो मेन पॉइंट रहते हैं, या तो हमेशा कुछ आपको डिवाइस करना होती है कोई पॉलिसी वगैरह, या वो आपको कुछ सेंक्शन देते हैं कि आप CSR के हेड हो, आपको इतना पैसा दिया, आपको ये करना है। उनके बस यही दो रहते हैं, इन्हीं के ऊपर उनके GT होते हैं।
GTs are all over situation, आपको एक situation they will give and you have to find a solution to that problem situation. And the way you approach that problem, that reflects your basically certain attitude as a professional. Group discussion is about your speaking skills. Group task is about your professional behavior which you display when some problem comes. So I will send you the link of GT also, which is there on YouTube. Your PD Education, IOCL, GT, if you put, there are so many videos on GT, which we have done. You watch that also, and we will do next time GT.
Sir, क्योंकि dates आने वाले हैं, 2-3 दिन ही बचे हैं, sir.
So you watch those videos which are there on your, आपको idea लग जाएगा उसमें काफी. आप वो videos भी देख लो, and then next we go for GT.
Okay, sir.
Right? Sir, so preferably tomorrow.
मेरा ये डाउट था कि कई बार क्या होता है, जैसे कोई इंसान बोल रहा है वो जब स्टॉप करता है और फिर कई सारे लोग एंटर करना चाहते हैं, तो अब ये डिस्कशन काफी स्मूथ था, जैसे एक कोई बोल रहा था तो दूसरा फिर चुप हो जा रहा था, बट मेनी टाइम्स होता है कि दोनों सेम पिच पे बोले ही जा रहे हैं, तो ऑफकोर्स वो चीज क्लियर नहीं होगी जो भी सुन रहा है, तो वहां पे बेस्ट चीज क्या होती है, लाइक हमें रुक जाना चाहिए या फिर वो करते रहना चाहिए?
practice. But in actual, I tell you, in actual GDs, you will not come across that chaotic situation. Actual GD ऐसे ही होगा जैसा यहाँ था, smooth होगा, मतलब कोई कुछ बोलेगा नहीं, क्योंकि वो डरते भी हैं, लोग बच्चे डरते हैं कि ऑब्जर्वर पेनलाइज ना कर दे, तो ज्यादा क्योस नहीं फैलाते हैं वहां पे, दे आर नॉट क्रिएटिंग डिस्टरबेंस, सो माय ऑब्जर्वेशन इज दैट दे विल नॉट क्रिएट क्योस, दे विल बी आराम से सुनेंगे, लेकिन यहाँ प्रैक्टिस करते करते क्योटिक हो जाता है और वो अच्छी चीज है, सो दैट यू गेट द फील ऑफ टर्बुलेंट वाटर।
सर जैसे कि अभी आपने थोड़ी देर पहले बोला था कि कुछ लोग लिख रहे थे तो नीचे देख रहे थे, जीडी की तरफ ध्यान नहीं दे रहे, मान लीजिए सर मैं सुनते सुनते मतलब सामने की तरफ ध्यान भी है और मैं लिख भी रहा हूँ, तो ये पॉजिटिव व्यू देगा वहां पर या नेगेटिव व्यू देगा?
बिल्कुल पॉजिटिव, इसमें क्या नेगेटिव क्या है इसमें, आपने एक वर्ड लिखना, डोंट राइट सेंटेंस, जस्ट राइट वर्ड।
कभी कभी क्या होता है कि सामने वाले ने कोई अच्छा पॉइंट बोला लेकिन मुझे उसका नाम याद नहीं है कि किसने बोला, तो मुझे नाम लिख के उसका पॉइंट लिखना पड़ता है, अच्छा इसने ये बोला था,
ठीक है, कंक्लूजन में तो आपको यूज याद करना पड़ेगा ना, बट बहुत ज्यादा ऐसा नहीं कि सिर नीचे रख के लिखे पड़े हो, ऐसा नहीं करो,
नहीं नहीं आंखें सामने और हाथ है,
हाँ यस, जैसे आप देखो कई बार मैं भी लिख रहा होता हूँ यहाँ पे, देख भी रहा होता हूँ लिख भी रहा होता हूँ, तो उससे ऐसा लग जाता है कि मैं लिख भी रहा हूँ देख भी रहा हूँ, सो दिस डिस्कशन में यू शुड मेंटेन आई कॉन्टेक्ट विद पीपल, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट।
सर ऑफलाइन जीटी में नाम तो नहीं लेना होगा ना, लाइक यहाँ पे तो सबके नाम दिख रहे हैं, वहां पे जब जाएंगे तो
वहां पे जब जाओगे नहीं नहीं वहां पे जब जाओगे उसका एक तरीका है, उसका तरीका क्या है मैंने वो उन तीनों वीडियोस में डिस्कस किया है, जब आप डिस्कशन करने जाओगे तो आप पहले आपको पता होता है दीज आर द गाइस आई एम गोइंग टू हैव डिस्कशन विद, तो उनके साथ आप थोड़ा वैसे बोलो हाय मेरा नाम सत्यार्थ है, तो वो आगे वाले मैं रुपेन हूँ, तो आप उसका नाम याद कर लो, वहाँ तीन चार लोगों के नाम याद कर लो जाने से पहले, उनसे इंट्रोड्यूस करो अपने आपको एंड जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ 2-3 स्टूडेंट्स विच विल हेल्प यू इन द कंक्लूजन बिकॉज यू विल बी ओनली नोइंग अबाउट देम नोबडी एल्स। And when he's speaking and if you ask him by name that Rupen what you are saying is true, so Rupen will stop. If you call somebody by name then he stops. That is knee-jerk reaction. So if you remember the names of the candidate before you enter the room, that helps you. So you can do that.
Sometimes number of students are less, sometimes बहुत ज़्यादा भी हो सकते हैं. कई ग्रुप जैसे 10 या 11 में भी हो
रहा है. आपको सबके नाम याद नहीं रखने हैं, 3-4 के रखने हैं जितने रख सकते हो. बस 3-4. कोई 3-4 के नाम याद रख लो. It will work. This works. सबके तो वैसे भी याद नहीं रखने ना, आप सबके याद कर सकते हो. And उसको याद रखो. That is 3-4 नाम याद रखो. उससे काम हो जाएगा. Right?
Yes, sir.
Anything else? Pradeep, you want to ask anything? You need to unmute yourself. Pradeep, unmute yourself.
Yes. Now it's okay, sir.
Speak.
Sorry. Sir, it was my first time in GD, sir, and also I was not aware about the topic, what today we have did, sir. And the time when we log in, on that time only I get that topic. So we have to discuss on that topic. Notwithstanding that, sir, this was a healthy topic and also discussion was good, sir. And I want to continue it because it was my three and the first class, first ZB. I have also not enrolled for that one. But now I want to continue that one. And I have hardly 15 days or 20 days because I have to participate in some GD, sir. So how can I continue if you can give some
talk to here, talk to call, yes. Some your PD executive must have permitted you for discussion. Talk to her. You are allowed here by some
executive. Yes, sir.
Talk to her. And second is you make your this system proper tomorrow. Listening system properly, yeah. This is creating disturbance. Okay, I make it good so that you can discuss.
Right, sir. I will do it, sir. Right. Thank you very much.
Anything you want to say? Okay, then see you tomorrow. Most probably we'll do group task tomorrow. Fine, at the same time. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, sir. Good night.